Good morning, everyone, and welcome to St. Agnes. Today we gather and celebrate both St. Agnes and St. Kieran, this liturgy.
Reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, O my people, I will open your graves and have you rise from them and bring you back to the land of Israel. Then you shall know that I am the Lord when I open your graves and have you rise from them, O my people. I will put my spirit in you, that you may live, and I will settle upon your land. Thus you shall know that I am the Lord. I have promised, and I will do it, says the Lord. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are in the flesh cannot please God. But you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, although the body is dead because of sin, the Spirit is alive because of righteousness. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit dwelling in you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Many of the Jews who had come to Mary and seeing what Jesus had done, began to believe in him. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we celebrate the fifth Sunday of Lent. Normally this would be a day we celebrate with our candidates and catechumens, our third scrutiny. But we now live in a time where nothing is normal. Today our gospel though helps us, it gives us questions and leads us in this time. It's a story packed with symbolism and questions for the followers of Christ. As the story begins, we're reminded of the friendship that exists between Jesus, Lazarus, Mary, and Martha. In today's world, we're reminded that relationships can still remain strong, even though we're asked to physically distance ourselves from one another. Through technology, through phone, through waves, we can connect with one another. Lazarus dies in the story, and Jesus tells his disciples that it's time to go to Bethany. It's time to see Mary and Martha. Thomas tells the disciples, "Well, let us go along. We'll go and die with him." It's a reminder to us that on this journey, together with the virus, we are all one. There's no distinction. We walk together. We do not face the virus alone. When Jesus and his disciples arrived at Bethany, Martha ran out of the village to meet him. During difficult times, we're reminded we need to seek God out. When Martha and Jesus met, Martha makes a profound profession of faith. "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would never have died." And she follows it up with, "I know he will rise again on the resurrection in the last day." This is our faith. This is our hope. We will rise from this pandemic and all the other difficulties of our lives, and we will once again share in God's joy and glory. Jesus asks the sisters, "Where have you laid him?" He was taken to the tomb, and Jesus tells them to take the stone away. Though they have just professed their faith in Jesus, they still hold on to their worries and fears. We also daily hold on to our worries and fears. "Lord, it's been 4 days. Surely there'll be a stench." 4 days, 4 weeks, 4 months. This is our journey with the COVID virus. Do we trust that there'll be a light on the other side of this virus? Martha and Mary finally believe it's possible. They open the tomb. Lazarus is called out, and Jesus calls him to come into the light. The bindings are removed, and life begins again. We too will be called out of our own tombs. The sin, the habits, the attitudes that entomb us will be removed, and we will once again walk in the light. This has been our faith all our lives. But now the virus brings it out in full force. The spontaneous singing that has arisen from the people of Italy, Spain, and New York remind us that our spirit and faith is never defeated. We are strong, and we are one in Christ. This morning, as we profess our faith, we'll use our Apostles' Creed. "I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord,
who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us place our trust in God as we offer our prayers for the needs of the world around us.
For the Church, may we shine the light of Christ to the whole world through our works of charity and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all communities, may they care for the hungry at the table, the homeless in the street, and the refugee at the border. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, especially victims of the coronavirus, may they find healing and comfort during their suffering. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they rest in peace with our Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Glorious God, assured of your great love for us, we hope to witness your glory and the joy of everlasting life. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Hear us, Almighty God, and having instilled in your servants the teaching of the Christian faith, graciously purify us by the working of this sacrifice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as true man we wept for Lazarus his friend, and as Eternal God raised him from the tomb. Just as, taking pity on the human race, he leads us by sacred mysteries to new life. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We remember all you.
Freed at last from the wound of corruption, and made fully into a new creation,
we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Helped us as we begin these celebrations online. On Palm Sunday, we will celebrate at St. Kieran. Please know, tell your friends and family on behalf of Father Tom, Father Amir, myself, and all of the staff, we are together in prayer, and we are together strong. Let us pray. Pray, Almighty God, that we may always be counted among the members of Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks, everybody.